Let's go to line two, Flow of Wisdom Radio. This is Sean Anthony. Hello.
Yeah, I want to talk about something you touched on a little bit earlier. One, for people, if anybody who don't, who think like, oh, you're making up your stories about the sounds before the earthquake, tell them to just go to WorldStar and type in earthquake. Several people across the world who've had earthquakes, who've had floods, they've been recording, and they actually have that sound, that truck sound, recorded.
Hmm.
And it's not just here in Virginia. It's all over the world that this is happening. Another thing, a lot of people don't know, living in Virginia, if anything catastrophic happens, we do have safe places that you can go that the government has built, but the only catch to that is any paintings, art figures, or anything that's history goes in there first. If they can get the art stuff in there first, you're screwed. So you can't get in there. And another thing is, a gentleman asked, where do we come from as black people? A lot of people know, but they don't dig into it. We come from Egypt. And what frustrates me is we come from pharaohs and queens and stuff like that. And on Discovery Channel and in history, always remember, the winners write the book, not the losers. So what they do is, on Discovery Channel, is show little villages in Africa. They don't show, like, those full-on streets and, you know, where we really, really did come from. Like our pharaohs, the paintings, and the fact that we are the original people to create books and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
But whenever a great nation comes around, something happens that wipes it away. And I believe when our people, as the Egyptians, were wiped away, that's probably the beginning what made us forget that we come from a great nation, a smart nation. Yeah, that's what I think.
Okay. Thank you so much for your call. I appreciate your patience as well for holding, all right?
All right.
Thank you. Makes some great points. Makes a lot of great points. Before I go to line three, I want to share with you, when that earthquake happened in Missouri that I touched on, that 4.0, and I read the lady's comments that she heard a sound, I contacted Will Allen, who was, you know, my guest. I played, you know, the clip of what he said. He said he heard a sound before the Virginia earthquake that sounded like a semi-truck. And in conclusion, he thought, his opinion, that it was some sort of underground nuclear explosion. Well, I sent Will Allen the link when I found out about that Missouri earthquake last week or a week and a half ago. And he hit me back with another link. And I'll read it. It says, August 24th, 2011, Russia reports nuclear explosions hit vast U.S. military tunnel network. Mystery trumpet sound by Sorcha Fowl, and as reported to her Western subscribers. And it's an interesting article where it basically talks about these strange sounds and where it came from. So apparently there was something going on underground. There was another thing that Will Allen said on that show a few weeks ago when he was on Flow of Wisdom Radio, that there's underground bunkers. You know, there's underground bunkers that, you know, I guess they're harboring aliens or other life form or what have you. But those were some of his statements. Let's go to line three. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. I'm Sean Anthony. Hello.
Hey, how you doing, man? It's Will.
I'm pretty good. What's going on, Will?
Hey, Will, man. Sean Anthony, you know, we've been back and forth. You know, we talked about some things on Twitter, man. And, you know, it's funny how we're experiencing, you know, all the things that we actually are going through, and we're seeing a lot of things. Information generation is really, really waking up. And it's funny how a lot of the information that is given to us While it is very informative and has a lot of truth behind it, it still also has the possibility of being jaded. A lot of people have, the spirit of self-promotion, and they want to be recognized. Like, for example, we had the guy from last year who, said the world was going to end on this particular day, and, that was like the third time he had said that. And, of course, you get books, and there's a lot of different things that people benefit from by putting out, very, very, very radical information. However, I do believe that there are a lot of things that do really exist. I do believe in HAARP. I do, definitely believe in the chemtrail situation. But just last week, I was on YouTube, and I was always, in a spirit of just finding out more information. But, I'm searching on YouTube, and I'm looking for something. And so I stumbled across this video saying, will mankind ever destroy itself? And it's a quantum physicist that's really explaining the difference between a type 0 to a type 1 to a type 2 civilization. It's a very, very interesting series. If you go to YouTube, it's a series called Big Think. And all these series are actually doing is they're trying to explain to us that maybe we're in a transition to a new way of living. And so, I was always against the whole Illuminati New World Order and all that stuff. Based off of the information that is given to us about Freemasons and all that other stuff, it does seem a little scary. However, I'm also a student at Virginia Union School of Theology, and, I'm studying my Master's in Divinity. I'm an associate minister. I'm on my way to church this morning. I'm not really, really going to close my mind as to say that maybe this information is jaded, because truth be told, a lot of the organized religions are the ones that are actually oppositional to the new way of thinking or the new way of living. Like, all this information that you're bringing here right now, you couldn't talk about this in your typical church or your typical mosque,
right?
Mainly because it would cause an uproar. And so the question really is the new world order or the transition from going to a new planetary society where we play with the weather, where we, where we have an ability to harness all the energy that the earth has, is that the evil, or is it the monotheistic or mono-unitarian culture of having, this is what my God is, this is what I believe, and, it's so amazing, and I can talk for, hours and want to, build with you, but it's funny how if you go back to what the dude Jesus was saying, I don't want to make this a religious conversation, but, Jesus started off by saying, hey, the Lord God is one God, whatever you believe in, love the Lord, your God with all your heart, mind, and soul. He didn't say love the Lord our God. He didn't say love the Lord my God. He said love the Lord your God. So he's giving you the forefront to say that, look, everything that you want to believe in, it doesn't matter. It's still one God. So there's so many different views and so many different ideas and mindsets of saying, okay, Christianity is better than Islam, or Islam is better than Hinduism, or Buddhism is better than. But at the end of the day, those are all organized schools of thought. But God created all of us to be individually different and unique. And so, we're at a real, real transition phase to where it may seem scary, but it may seem scary because all of these people are putting out so many scare tactics.
Right.
And maybe God is, giving us an opportunity to live in a better way. I mean, think of the internet. I could talk to somebody in Japan right now within seconds.
Right.
There was never a way to be able to be connected on all different levels of the world. And so, I sent you the link on YouTube, man. Check it out, though. It's very interesting how, they pose it as if maybe this whole new way of, look at English. Everybody across the world speaks English. We're becoming a Unitarian society. There's a Unitarian perception of fashion. Everybody wears Chanel, Coach, Gucci, Prada. That's everywhere. That's global. And so there's a lot of things that are just becoming more global.
Yeah.
And so, we're...
The internet has shrunk the world. And I've seen your tweets. I just retweeted you too, Will. But yeah, man, thank you, man. I appreciate, you bring a lot of insight to the show, man. So I thank you for calling in as well, man. Call in more.
Oh, most definitely, man. Sean, keep doing what you're doing, man, because, regardless of whether we really know what we believe in, the best part is just waking up. And, my dean, and I'll leave it at this, and my dean Kenny, he asked us, he said, what is it that you believe? Because a lot of times we don't really express what it is that we believe. We just believe what somebody else recited to us, or what somebody else told us to believe. But a lot of times we don't really recite what the core essence of what we actually believe is. So, you're waking people up, and you're doing an amazing thing. So, man, keep doing what you're doing, man. Richmond loves you, dog.
Thank you, bro. Appreciate it, man. Thank you so much. Let's go to line one, Floor of Wisdom Radio. This is Sean Anthony. Hello.
Yeah, how are you, Sean? I'm calling about the conversation you were talking about.
Yes, thank you. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, I believe that knowledge is power, and the government making it so that we need them, and money is power. If you acknowledge that right now, your show, I rarely hear this on the radio, this type of conversation. And I acknowledge that. Look what time is being played on the radio. How much of the youth get to hear this? I don't think that nothing has changed. I mean, there's a lot of better opportunities now, but nothing really has changed than when, you know, the pilgrims came on the Plymouth. You understand where I'm coming from?
Yeah, I'm listening.
Yeah, so it's knowledge, and we lack it, and it's like for high school kids, they think that it's cool to be dumb.
Right.
You know, and that's really where it starts, especially in our community, our black community, knowledge. And that's the key. And somebody was saying, like, you know, back in the day, what did we praise? What did we do? If you look at the movies, history tell us that we called to our ancestors, you know. A lot of movies display a lot of things, but they only put out what they want us to see. And it's just knowledge, it's knowledge.
Yep.
And the lack of it, and it's hard for us to get to it. And if you go back to Frederick Douglass, the English tried to pay him out in order to erase slavery.
Yeah.
You know, so, I mean...
I will have to agree with you. You know, knowledge is key. Knowledge is power. Knowledge and wisdom. And then all, you know, you're getting, you got to get understanding. But thank you for your call. I got some other callers trying to get through, and I want to make sure I get to you. Let's go. Line two, Flow of Wisdom Radio. This is Sean Anthony. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, you still taking calls?
Yeah, go ahead. You're live.
Oh, I'm live. All right. Well, I was just tuning in. I didn't hear a topic of discussion, but I heard a couple of calls.
Yeah, well, basically, you know, I if you probably just tuned in, I have been recapping many topics that I've covered on the show for the past several months. And if you just tuned in, I played a couple of clips from some previous guests. I touched on the HAARP, the manipulation of the weather control, causing earthquakes. I talked about the Virginia earthquake, that people heard strange sounds before the earthquake. There was an earthquake in Missouri a couple of weeks ago. Lady said, that's quoted on MSNBC.com, said the same. She heard the same noises that my guest, Will Allen, heard when we had the Virginia earthquake. So I've been touching on many different things. Also talked about fluoride, how fluoride is in not only our toothpaste, but in our water. And, you know, it's toxins and stuff like that. So you want to comment on any one of those things, feel free.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Well, I mean, the thing is, I heard a lot of people say what we believe in. And the problem is we still believe too much and don't know things. Because you can be told anything. And when you saying, I believe, basically you're walking on an unsure assumption or something. You don't know. It's just a belief. And it's putting people in a bad position. When you know something, you're sure about it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's easy to deal with something that you're sure about. You can walk around believing a million things. Santa Claus got kids believing a million things. And every other little character in the world.
Oh. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Go ahead. I would say people believe in all this stuff, but what they know is that their mom and their dad get up and go to work. So power, that's just a simple and undeep way of saying how power is shifted out of the homes and out of people's mind to stop knowing about things and they believe. And as far as the HAARP thing, HAARP is real. People should know it exists and stop saying believe. Our terminology put us in bad situations, too.
Great points, man. Great points. I like it. Thank you, man. I appreciate it.